starting off with a happy 60th birthday to Ian Holdsworth, wonderful husband, father and granddad, lifelong supporter and shareholder. And now a full-time mom, Ben McCarrie, lots of love from all your family and friends. Happy 11th birthday to Isaac Sewell, lots of love from mum, dad and all the family. And happy 18th birthday to Peyton Easton, from everybody helping us celebrate the 1882 Lions today. And a happy 60th birthday to Ian Black, lots of love from all the family. Coming over, happy 80th birthday to Margaret Taylor. Lots of love from all your family who've travelled from miles around to be here on your special day. David and Rowan have travelled from Singapore, Christmas flying from Cape Town. Andrew has made a journey from the Democratic Republic of Congo. Sister Edna from Arnside has also made it to Turf Moor for today's game. Happy birthday, Mum, from all of us, and good luck to Burnley Football Club today. And finally, happy birthday to Karen Booth from all your friends at Sound White Saturday night. And just today's half-time game features Barnoldswick Town under-8s. So can you please give them a big round of applause as they play down here in front of the Drew McElroy and James Hargreaves stands. Right, we're going to do the Golden Gamble draw now. And today's half-time guest earned legendary status here at Turf Moor in the 1960s. To this day, Ray is one of the only four players to score five times in a game. He's out there on his own as the only one to achieve his feat twice. Alongside strike partner Willie Irving, they were hugely prolific in the mid-1960s, scoring 149 goals between them in three seasons. He made 265 appearances for the Pirates and still a popular local figure. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together and give a big Turf Moor welcome back to Andy Lockhead. So first of all, the bonus ball for today's game, and that is number two. If the winning ticket ends in a number two, the prize is £1,000. Remember last game it was a bonus ball number as well. So Andy's going to throw out the prizes now. So the first prize, which is a cash prize, your first ticket number is 11807. 11807 is your first prize, and that is a cash prize. The second prize for the signed home shirt is 11816. 11816 is your second prize. Your third prize is a £25 voucher to spend in the club shop, and that is 12064. 12064 is your third prize. Fourth prize is a signed ball. And that is 11659 is your fourth prize. Your fifth prize, final prize, a Milford Tour at the Rose and Bowl. And that one is 11835. 11835 is your fifth and final prize. So I'm going to just get this photograph taken there. So that concludes your draw now, but please put your hands together once again and say a big thank you there to Andy Lockhead. Ladies and gentlemen, the Burnley Football Club is proud to host an awareness day for cardiopulmonary resuscitation, more commonly known as CPR. Team Dr. Samuel Morris is the driving force behind today's event, which will now see members of the Northwest Ambulance Service demonstrating life-saving CPR techniques to volunteers on the pitch. So can you please give the volunteers your attention, because this could help you to save a life. I'm now going to hand you over to Northwest Ambulance Service Technician Sean Sproul for more details.
Good afternoon. Around the pitch side you'll see some of our volunteers, and all we're trying to do is raise awareness of CPR and what you can do to help people if they collapse and stop breathing.
There are times in life where being tough comes in handy. Say some gears are collapses in front of you. What do you do?
We need a volunteer that ain't breathing.
Here's what I made earlier. First off, you call 999.
I know.
Then,
no kissing.
You only kiss your missus on the lips. You push hard and fast here on the sovereign to stay alive. Remember, call 999. Push hard and fast to stay alive. Hands on your CPR.
Sounds hard as it looks. Sounds hard as it looks.
So, what would you do if the person in the seat next to you fell over, collapsed and stopped breathing? The first thing we need you to do is look all around for dangers. We don't want a second patient, we only want to keep it to one. After we've checked for dangers, when there is no danger, we need to check for a response on the person. So you need to get down close to them, shout in each ear, tell them you're there to help them. Give them a little shake, see if they respond. If they don't respond, you then need to open the airway. To open the airway, place the palm of one hand on the forehead and tilt the head back. Place two fingers under the chin and lift the chin up. This opens the airway, forcing the tongue down to block air going in and out. After you've opened the airway, you need to get down close and listen for breathing. You want to look for the chest rising and falling. You want to see if you can feel breath coming onto the side of your face. If need be, place your hand on the stomach to see if you can see your hand rising and falling. If you're not getting any breathing, you need to shout for help. Get somebody else to ring the ambulance service. You need to see and ask if there is an AED, a defibrillator, anywhere close. If so, send somebody to get it, because this could save the lives. After you've got help on its way, you then need to start with compressions. You need to do 30 compressions at a rate of 100 to 120 beats a minute. That's on average 2 per second. It is really important that we lock our arms in place and use our body weight, not our biceps, to do the compressions, or else we'll tire quickly. When we're doing the compressions, we need to push down a depth of 5 to 6 centimetres. On a child or a smaller person, we need to go a third of the depth of the body. After we've done our 30 compressions,